Much love to all.
"2010 Charges in the United States." Around the 29th of March 2010, Van der Sloot allegedly contacted John Q. Kelly, Beth Holloway's legal representative, with an offer to reveal the location of Natalie's body and the circumstances surrounding her death for an advance of $25,000 against a total of $250,000. Kelly said that he secretly went to Aruba in April to meet with Van der Sloot, who was desperate for money, and gave him $100. Kelly notified the FBI, which set up a sting operation with the Aruban authorities. On the 10th of May, Van der Sloot allegedly accepted the sum of $15,000 by wire transfer to his account in the Netherlands, following a cash payment of $10,000 that was videotaped by undercover investigators in Aruba. In exchange, Van der Sloot told Kelly that his father buried Holloway's remains in the foundation of a house. Authorities determined that this information was false, because the house had not yet been built at the time of Holloway's disappearance. Van der Sloot later emailed Kelly that he lied about the house. Beth Holloway was shocked that the FBI did not promptly file extortion charges against Van der Sloot, allowing him to leave freely with the money to Bogota on his way to Lima. The FBI and the Office of the U.S. Attorney contended that the case had not yet been sufficiently developed to enable filing the charges. On the 3rd of June 2010, the U.S. District Court of Northern Alabama charged Van der Sloot with extortion and wire fraud. U.S. Attorney Joyce White Vance issued an arrest warrant through Interpol to have him prosecuted in the United States. On the 4th of June, at the request of the U.S. Justice Department, Dutch authorities raided and confiscated items from two homes in the Netherlands, one of them belonging to reporter Jaap Ammes, who had previously interviewed Van der Sloot, and who claimed knowledge of his criminal activities. Aruban investigators used information gathered from the extortion case to launch a new search at a beach, but no new evidence was found. Aruba's Solicitor General's office stated they would not seek Van der Sloot's extradition to Aruba. On the 30th of June, a U.S. federal grand jury formally indicted Van der Sloot on the two charges. The indictment, filed with the U.S. District Court, sought the forfeiture of the $25,100 that had been paid to Van der Sloot. In an interview published by De Telegraaf on 6 September 2010, Van der Sloot admitted to the extortion plot, stating, "I wanted to get back at Natalie's family. Her parents have been making my life tough for 5 years. His attorney said that his client was not paid for the interview, and suggested instead that maybe there were some mistakes in the translation. On the 9th of March 2014, the Peruvian government announced that Van der Sloot would face extradition to the U.S. in the year 2038 to face charges of extortion and wire fraud, after completion of his 28-year sentence in Peru for the murder of Stephanie Tatiana Flores Ramirez. In February 2016, an undercover reporter filmed Van der Sloot confessing to Natalie Holloway's murder. The film shows Van der Sloot, in Dutch, laughing over how he never told the truth about the whole event and that he did in fact kill Holloway. His Peruvian wife is also present during this conversation.
I take this and I smash her head in with it completely. Her face basically, collapses in.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.